I was born in Newmarket, Ontario. It's about 45 minutes north of Toronto. Sports was always a big part of my life. My parents split up when I was six. My mom was kind of the disciplinarian, strict kind of mom teacher, and dad was kind of the fun guy and play a lot of sports and take us to his pickup basketball and baseball and all that kind of stuff. My father took his own life when I was 10 years old. I was in school and got the call from my mom and came down to the office, and she took me and my brother home. They told us that he, dad was gone, and so I remember crying right away, but then after that, kind of not really knowing what was going on. You can't really take that in as a 10-year-old, I don't think. Didn't know right away that he took his own life. That was a couple years later. I found that out. Made you pretty angry that he didn't want to be around for your life, didn't want to see you become a man, wasn't important enough to him, so that's how you take it, I think, right away. And I held on to that for a long time, I think. Definitely a weird thing to go through as a 10-year-old, to try to, you know, I was the man of the house, I guess you could say, after that. I lost a lot of confidence when my dad passed. I think he was the one that really pushed the hockey. So being able to talk to someone about what that would have been huge, and it didn't happen until I was a lot older, like 17. Once I was able to talk about it, I truly think that that was the start of the healing process. The dam kind of broke, and then that's when I kind of realized that I needed to talk about it. Which, if I could have done that at a younger age where I was encouraged to talk, probably would have been a lot less angry. And probably just would have been a lot more smoother transition into like moving on with life. Just through my mom, through my family, and just them supporting me so much. Like, my mom's been amazing. I think that's a big part of getting over something like this. You need people in your corner, and yeah, it really strengthened the bond between us. Mom became dad too. I think realizing that, you know, my father's suicide wasn't all about me was probably the biggest breakthrough. For me to realize, like, hey, he had a mental illness that he did not talk to anybody about enough. It wasn't my fault. It's not any guilt on me. I don't need to carry this with me. I can let this go. And it was a problem that he had that I wish I could have helped him with. I really think I did use my father's passing as a motivator for a long time. I definitely turned that into, okay, well, I'm gonna show him that I can be one heck of a guy, and he's not gonna be around to see it. Like, he's not gonna be around to see me become the man I'm gonna be. Yeah, I mean, scoring my first NHL goal was unbelievable.
Sini wins the draw. Look at a quick shot from Gabriel. Curtis Gabriel with his first goal as a New Jersey Devil, I believe.
A lot of things go through your head. I think Dad popped up for a split second. He'd be really proud of me. Maybe he even thought I would get here one day. The best advice I have for kids these days, after losing a parent, would just to be to talk about it. Life starts when you get outside your comfort zone. Sharing the experience I've had with losing my father to suicide and my girlfriend losing her mother to cancer, both at a young age, I think has really made us closer. It's made us stronger. If she's having a bad day, or it's around the day of her mother's passing, that we can sit down and talk about it. And I think that's what really helps you heal, is talking about it and sharing that experience with other people. Just know that if you lost a parent like I did, you know, there's a lot more life to live. There's a lot of positives you can focus on. You can turn this negative part in your life into a positive. And I think if you just focus on the right things, you lean on the family members and your friends that you have around, you want to talk about it. Time heals wounds. I think talking about it heals wounds, and you can go out and chase life that you always wanted. I focus on the positives. I did focus on the negatives for a long time, but I think turning it into the positives has led me to really be where I really want to be in life, and I'm really excited for the future holds, and losing a parent didn't hold me back in any way.